For almost 2 years, this Syrian restaurant called Sufi's on Queen Street was open to make newcomers and all Syrians feel welcome. From the food to the decor to the wait staff, it was like a taste of home. But now the restaurant says they've been forced to close their doors because of alleged death threats.
We literally were coming here for coffee and food for lunch and going to take it to the park. And this is what we saw. I love this family. They're sweet. They've been nothing but kind to us. The food is amazing.
The storefront plastered with permanently closed posters, pointing the finger at alleged hate messages and death threats. The alleged harassment started after the son of the owner of Sufi's attended an anti-fascist protest in Hamilton a few days ago, which was held outside an event where the leader of the People's Party of Canada, Maxime Bernier, was speaking. Bernier is known for his stance against immigration and has faced criticism for calling diversity nonsense. It got a little out of hand when 81-year-old Dorothy Marston was called Nazi scum while trying to enter the venue.
We would like to reiterate that our son Allah regrets the incident that occurred in Hamilton this past weekend. That said, he did not in any way verbally or physically assault the elderly woman and has nonetheless offered to apologize personally for not doing more. Allah has been an activist and humanitarian for the past 9 years, fighting for the rights of oppressed communities in Canada and worldwide.
Patrons have been passing by the restaurant all day, leaving notes and flowers, upset by the abrupt closure, shocked by the accusations.
We have the rule of law in Canada. There's a procedure for how this is dealt with. If there's any complaints that people have about how, you know, a family member may have behaved, then that's how we do go about things here. We don't issue death threats. This is not this kind of country.
When you get a death threat for participating in a protest, right, where does that leave room for people to come back to the middle ground?
The family spokesperson says the restaurant owners are grateful for the messages of support, but they don't want to put family members, staff, and patrons in danger.
On Sunday, our son was doxxed and physically assaulted, and our family has received many death threats that have left us feeling unsafe.
I think it's awful. I think anybody receiving any kind of hate is terrible, and the fact that they had to close down their business that they started and invested so much time and money into, it's really sad.
The community love you, and we really want you to open up again if you can possibly, but we're very, very sorry this has happened to you. You have contributed so much to the community.
Toronto police say the restaurant contacted them back on October 2nd, but they did not file a full report, which is why an investigation isn't taking place. They are urging the owners to come forward. On Queen Street West, Maleeha Sheikh, City News.